Well, hello. In River Talk this week, we meet 69-year-old Bill Upton from Redcar, whose family had been connected with Redcar Lifeboat for years and years. Bill's got a nickname, so I began by asking how he came to be known to his friends as Pockets.
Well, I think it was one of the old Mark Baker chap family. I used to have a jacket where there were so many pockets, you know, and then when they asked me to, if I wanted anything, I'd go in this pocket and then that, and he said, I think I'll call those pockets, he says. That was Mark Baker.
Right. Now, Bill, right. You've got a long history, your family's a long history of connections with the Redcar Lifeboat. Do you remember how it all began?
Well, the great-grandfather, old Will Upton, he was coxswain in 1869 to about 1875, I think. And then the Barnacles, the brothers, one was second coxswain, the other was coxswain. And then the granddad, he came to be second coxswain to one of the Barnacles. And then he eventually got to be coxswain in 1906. And he was coxswain until 1923. That was of course the 15th Charles. But he was second coxswain in the Brothers. That's the lifeboat before the 15th Charles. Of course they were rowing boats in those days. A lot harder work than what it is now, where you've got the motors, the tractors to launch it. And when those it was launched by hand. My first recollections of the lifeboat, I was 7 year old. That was in 1909, with the fishing disaster. It was a quiet morning, and I went down the yard. We lived at 113 High Street, where Jackson's shop is now. And of course the backyard went straight onto the prom. We lived there. Well, I had to go down when they went off, even as far as 5 o'clock in the morning then. I had to go down with them, pull the wheels up after they'd gone up, pull the wheels up to high water, you see, and then run back and tell the old lady that'd gone, put the kettle on for some tea, light the fire, and go down into the shed and fetch two or three buckets of mussels up. And I had to help to skin those mussels, that's opening them, you see. I had to sit and help to skin those mussels, and then she'd say, it's time those way to school, Willie, 8:30. You wash the hands and away they go to school.
This was as a lad of seven?
I was 7 year old then, aye. Because I had to go to school then.
Bill, do you have any amusing memories?
I wouldn't say I laughed over it. But a few months before I retired, once the rockets went off, somewhere about midnight, and I went down to launch the boat, and it was a funny sort of a sound, bells. You couldn't launch the boat because there was a bell further on, so of course you had to shove further and further in, you see. And the tractor broke down. Well, we'd got in sufficiently. Oh, we were well in. And the lifeboat practically floated off, you see. So, tide was flowing. And I tried to start, and of course the engine was dead. So I shouted at coxswain, throw the belt, you see. And he backed alongside, threw me this belt, and away they went, left me to it. And I think I was there an hour. So at the finish, I had to climb on top of the tractor with his leg belt on, plugged all the exhaust, because they can travel on the water, those things, you know, for so long. Plugged the exhaust, and I waited there. 1 o'clock come. My lights had gone. I couldn't signal to coast guard, you know. So they must have thought, well, there's something wrong ashore. And anyway, a boat puts off, pulls alongside, and one of them says, jump, Bill. I says, because he was frightened to come alongside, fear he stove in on the tractor side, say, because there was a bit of swell. I says, what do I want to jump for? I've got a belt on. Anyway, I got on a stand at board and they pulled me in to come ashore. And when I come ashore, one of them says, what's the matter? I said, what's the matter? I said, you damn well left me out there an hour. I said, surely you knew something was wrong. He said, why didn't you signal? I said, oh, how could I signal? The lights had gone. So anyway, I come home and got changed. And of course, next morning, the tractor was low water. The tractor, when I looked how far the tractor there was, well, I got a shock on the old cox and Joey Hall. He said, how did you get that far out? I said, well, you go till the coxswain blows his whistle. He said, aye. He said, you shouldn't have gone that far. I said, well, there were them bells. Aye, well, he said, aye, that's right. And of course, I laughed after, but...
pretty embarrassing.
If there'd been any more sea coming,
yes.
It could have been a bit dodgy. But I won't say, you don't get much to laugh at, really.
On the wild and wasteful ocean, it's out there on the deep that we harvest our bread. As we hunt the bonny shores of heaven. It was on a fair and a pleasant day, out of Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger, for to hunt the bonny shoals of Erin. Oh, we left the home grounds in the month of June, and for canny shields we soon were bearing. With 100 crown of the silver darlings that we taken from the shoals of Erin. Now the work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment sure it took some bearing. And I used to sleep standing on me feet, and I dream about the shoals of Erin. You're up on deck, you're a fisherman, and you're learning all about seafaring. That's your education, scraps of navigation, as you hunt the bonny shoals of Erin.
Okay, what was your worst experience with a lifeboat? There's probably one that stands out, is there? A particular night or a particular rescue?
Well, it was night time again. And sea was heavy, and I shoved the lifeboat in, and the sea broke more sideways than I was else. I mean, I was to get more wet through than the fellas in the boat, because that tractor is not like this one. This one's very high. Well, the old tractor was fairly low, and of course sea used to break over you. And I got washed off, and I grabbed on one hand on the driving wheel. And pulled myself. If I hadn't, I'd have been. And of course, I had no belt on that time. And I think that's the worst I remember. Of course, as far as going in the boat's concerned, I was only in it once. That's a long, long time ago. And the old chap was coxswain at the time. And when we come ashore, he says, "I think there'll be a short job." He says, "There wasn't heavy enough to pull off." There weren't big fellas in them days, you know.
It's a tough job, yeah.
And the next time there was a bit of a lunch. The old coxswain of the Tees boat, he's retired a year or two back, Johnny Stonehouse, probably you'll know him, big chap. We were both stood at the lifeboat corner, rockets had gone off, and I think there were a man short. Well, the old chap looked, and of course his sister Johnny, "Come on, get in." He picked him because he was bigger and heavier than me, see? And of course, I think that was the start of Johnny's experience in the lifeboat. And of course, I think we were only about 18, 19 year old then, pair of us. But, I don't know, it's... how many times I wonder, was it worthwhile putting all that time in? But I mean, if the sea's in your blood, well, you do that sort of thing, don't you?
Thank you.
Oh,